everyone, I'm back, and who likes magical girls here? Whether it's Sailor Moon or Cardcaptor Sakura, or even Lollirock, Winx, and Miraculous Ladybug, you are surely going to love Adorned by Chi. Adorned by Chi is created by Jacques, and it tells the story of five college students who are chosen by goddesses to fight the forces of evil. Magical girls in West Africa, where have you been all my life? And so I'm gonna give you guys three reasons that you should go pre-order the manga. So number one, the art. Can I give a major kudos to Mangus Ato capturing the essence of Nigeria through the setting and mostly through the characters. My favorite character design has got to be Gogo in her goddess form. She's beautiful, she's graceful, and she's a total badass. She has an awesome staff, and the markings on her face really add touch. You can tell by the personality of the characters through their design. We have a shy one, we have a chill one, and we have a goth one. I mean, Kelechi, she's like the Wednesday Addams of the group. I mean, come on. So you should totally see the visuals. They look amazing. Number two, the creativity put into the manga. I really love the fact that Adorned by Chi is also based off of Igbo mythology. In finishing up the second issue, there's a one page that you'll learn about the Igbo culture. And even though Nigeria is a neighboring country to Senegal, I'm still fascinated how the culture is put into the series. For example, the monster. Beware of the Manyu. So can we give a round of applause for the author's mother? And last but certainly not least, number three, the plot. Yep, it's awesome that they can transform into goddesses, they have superpowers, they can fight evil, but it doesn't change the fact that they're still human dealing with their own problems. With Adaze, she's dealing with social anxiety and she's still not over the traumatic past she had. And we have Kelechi who's being treated differently just because she's albino. An interesting fact, albinos in Africa are known to be like a witchcraft ingredient. And let's just say that they're being turned into magical dust, which is not pretty. But hey, at the end of the day, the best thing you can deal with those problems is self-care. Hope I cheat cheat the adorable dumpling that I would love to adopt. As an African girl who loves anime, it warms my heart to see that Igbo anime fans have characters that look like them and that they're from their culture. So major kudos to Jack for creating such an amazing manga. I am rooting for you. You are going to take the world by storm, and I can't wait to see it turn into an anime. And if I had to pick an animation studio, I would think Toei Animation because of the way they animated Miraculous Ladybug. Or if not, let me just look up because I forgot the name. Batman Entertainment because of the way they portrayed magic and magi. I mean, it would be awesome to see that, right? What do you think? For those who have already read Adorned by Chi, which animation studio in Japan should animate the manga? Put the comments down below and let me know. And do check out the manga. The digital copies are in their website. I put the link down below. And as well as the theme song that is also featured in YouTube. So go check it out. And be sure to leave them a review once you're done reading. And let me know what you think. Give me a thumbs up that it's an awesome manga to read this year. And give me a thumbs up that you now have a little crush on Emika because he's such a charming boy. Give a thumbs up to the author for creating such an awesome story. And subscribe to more of my videos where there's life, positivity, and anime. And be sure to take care of yourself. See you guys. Bye. And thank you, Adorned by Chi, for featuring my fan art. Much appreciated.